A very good morning to all my kids. Today we will be starting with a new chapter of geography, and the name of the chapter is North America, the land of prairies. Before getting started with the lesson, I want you all to see a small and beautiful video of the land of prairies. Students, in this chapter you will learn about the physical setting, location, extent, and you will also get to know about richness and lakes of North America. And you will also understand how North America developed industries by utilizing minerals. Students, North America is recently discovered continent. In 1501, the Italian navigator Amerigo Vespucci sailed to the coast of mainland. Then the continent was called by the first word of his name, Amerigo, that is America. And the continent is mostly inhabited by Europeans. They made use of Mexico's gold. The picture which you are seeing on the screen is just an example for you girls to observe how the coin looked like. And the people of those days used to use the same coin for trading purpose, or if they wanted to purchase anything, or if they wanted to exchange in form of anything, they used to do it through it. Students, and the French built up a profitable fur trade in Canada. What they did is they used to sell the skin, the fur of the animal in Canada. Okay, like in the winters they use, even now they use the fur because it keeps us warm, right? Why do you like teddy bear? Because it's soft. The upper layer of this teddy is soft. If you go and purchase a good quality of teddy bear, it will be made out of animal fur. Okay, so they used to make a trade, use the fur in trade. The British exploited the fisheries and forests of the Atlantic provinces of Canada, of New England, of USA. So what they did is they started to make a business. Okay, they had captured all the fisheries, like fishing things and all. They used to take all the fishing thing. They cut it down the tree and they started a business out of that. And all these things had given them a huge number of profit, okay? It was a very profitable business for the French. And the sound resource base combined with development in science and technology, a large domestic market, international trade relationship, development of good means of transportation, etc., have helped North America to become one of the most developed regions of the world. So the nations of North America are very rich and called one of the economically prosperous countries. Therefore, it is necessary to understand the continent as a model for the progress of other continents. Okay, and because they had used all their natural resources and their technologies, that's the reason, you know, people look up for, like we look up, right? USA is this, USA is that. Why? So that even the other continents or other countries can make use of these things. Now let's learn about location, physical setting and extents. Students, North America is located entirely to the north of the equator. It lies within 19 degree north to 71 degree north latitudes and 50 degree west to 150 degree west longitudes. The Tropic of Cancer passes through the continent in south and the Arctic Circle in the north. Students, this was the exact location where North America is situated. Now let's learn about the physical setting. Okay, in physical setting, we will learn about the oceans, their main rivers which are present in North America. So let's go ahead and learn about them. Students, North America is surrounded by Atlantic Ocean in the east, the Pacific Ocean in the west, and the Arctic Ocean in the north. It is separated from continent of Asia by Bering Strait, and it has a land link with South America by Isthmus of Panama. A number of small water bodies are found here.
Like example,
for example, the Gulf of Mexico,
the Hudson Bay,
the Gulf of Alaska, Gulf of California,
etc. Found in the Siberian Sea.
And so Cuba Islands are found in Caribbean Sea. Newfoundland land is found to the east of Canada. A number of islands lie in the Arctic Ocean, of which Greenland is the largest. The strip of land that lies to South and North America is called Central America. Now let's learn about extent. Student, North America is the third largest continent in area in the world after Asia and Africa. It is almost 7 times bigger than India. There are 24 countries in North America, Canada and United States of America and Mexico are the three large continents by their size. The Caribbean islands are also area included in the physical area of North America. So students, North America continent has 24 countries in it, and Canada, United States of America, and Mexico are the three largest islands by their sizes.
So what?
Now let's learn about the physical division. Students, the continent of North America is divided into four major physical divisions, and they are the Western Cordilleras or the Rocky Mountains, the Great Central Plains, the Appalachian Highlands and the Coastal Plains. Let's study about the Western Cordilleras first. Students, these are the young folded mountain ranges like Himalayas of India. The Western Cordilleras run from Alaska in the north to Panama in south. They consist of series of plateaus, for example, Colorado, Mexican Yucatan Plateau, and form a series of parallel folded mountains. And the Rockies are important ranges in the Western Cordilleras. The height of the range is low towards Alaska and increases enormously towards Mexico. Mount McKinley, the height of McKinley is 6,194 meter, is the highest peak, and Death Valley, that is the lowest part of this region. The Cascade and the Sierra Nevada are the other ranges. The Whitney Mountain and the White Mountain in California are well known for their rugged slope and scenic beauty. There are some intermountain plateaus found between these ranges. Now let's study about the Great Central Plains. Students, the Central Plains are also referred to as the Great Plains of the Prairies. They lie between the Appalachians in the east and the Cordilleras in the west. The plain consists of vast expanse of flat to gently rolling land. These plains are formed by river Mississippi and Missouri and their tributaries. And this is one of the most fertile plain of the world, and it is good for farming region. Okay, farming, if you do farming, it's very good for that. It's suitable for farming. The denudation of the area by ice sheet has resulted in the formation of a large number of basins. These basins are covered by lakes. Let's study about the Eastern Highlands or the Appalachians. On the screen, you can see the picture of the Appalachians. Students, the Eastern Highland is also known as Appalachians. These extend from Newfoundland to Alabama along the eastern margin of the continent. Students, the Appalachians are folded mountains but have been denuded to their present height. East of the Appalachian ranges lie in the Piedmont Plateau and the Atlantic Coastal Plain. The St. Lawrence Valley separates the Labrador Plateau from the Appalachian ranges. They are rich in coal, lead, zinc, iron ore, copper, water power, and wood. Now let's study about the coastal plains. Kids, North America has quite a long and indented coastal line, except in the south where the isthmus of Panama. The coastal plain is narrow in the northeast and it gets wider when it goes toward the south and west. The average height is 150 meter above the sea level. This is a low and relatively plain area with sandy soils, which is relatively infertile. We can't do farming on this land. Swamps and the marshes are abundant. The coast is indented by river mouths and bays on which many seaports are located. Now let's learn about rivers and Great Lakes. Students, North America has a few large and short rivers, a number of lakes from unique physical features of this continent around the Canadian Shield. The Mississippi and its tributaries forms a great river system of North America. And these together drains 2/3 of the area of the continent and finally flows into the Gulf of Mexico. The Missouri is the important tributary of Mississippi. The other tributaries are Red River, Hoy, Tennessee, Arkansas, the Snake, Fraser, Columbia, Yukon, Colorado, Rio Grande. And now on the screen you can see Fraser. And you can also see Mackenzie, Nelson, and St. Lawrence on the map. The Colorado, Columbia, and the Fraser are the west flowing rivers. They are short and swift and flows into the Pacific Ocean. River Colorado and River Columbia are the west flowing river and they are short and swift. The River Columbia flows across the Columbian Plateau. The Colorado River drains into Colorado Plateau and forms a Grand Canyon. And it is a center for scenic beauty and tourism. The Grand Canyon is called Natural Wonder of the World.
And salt water. Lakes. Fresh
North
water
America has a large number of fresh water and salt water lakes. They are situated on the southern border of Canadian Shield. Huron, Ontario, Michigan, Erie, and the Superior are the important lakes. Together they are called homes. Lake Superior is the largest of the Great Lakes and it is the largest freshwater lake. Freshwater lake is the water which you can drink, okay, in the world. Chicago and the Detroit are situated on the Michigan and Erie lakes respectively. In Canada, Lake Winnipeg is very important. Great Lakes serves as important waterways. Now let's study about climate and natural vegetation. North America has a wide range of climate due to its vast latitudinal extent, a varied relief features and many more. It includes extreme weather conditions ranging from freezing condition in Alaska and Greenland to burning heat in the desert of southwest USA and southeastern Florida. The Caribbean and the Central America have tropical conditions. The eastern half of North America is more humid. Central and southern regions of the continent are prone to surf storms, including hurricanes and tornadoes. Natural vegetation. Students, natural vegetation and animal life largely depend on the climate, soil and relief features. Due to the great diversity in climate and relief, North America has a wide variety of vegetation. These vegetation belts broadly follow the climate regions. They are the tundra type of vegetation found within the Arctic Circle. It is found in Canada, Alaska, and Greenland. During winters, because the winters are long and freezing and summer are very short, the only vegetation found here are mosses and lichens. Some stunt flowering plants are grown in summer seasons. The animals which survive in hard and harsh conditions are reindeer and caribou and carnivores like polar bears and Arctic foxes. South of tundra belt lies on the cold temperature type of climate region. And this is actually a belt of coniferous forest called taiga. Deciduous type is found in east and southeast of St. Lawrence River and Great Lakes. Northern part is cold and southern part of this region remains warm. Winters are cold but summers are warm and rainfall occurs usually in summers. The trees found here shed their leaves in autumn. The coniferous and the deciduous trees are found in temperature mixed forest. Canada and North California have such forest. The important trees found in this region are birch, peach, maple, and oak. You can see this images of those trees on the screen. Now let's study about agriculture. Students, agriculture is an important occupation in North America. Central lowlands of continent, especially Canada and USA, are very productive agriculture countries. Only 10% of the total area of North America is suitable for agriculture. But the production from their farms is very high because large farms, rich soil, adequate irrigation, merchandise farming, or you can say machinized farming, or other facilities with human efforts make North America one of the largest agriculture regions of the world. Regions specialized in the production of specific crops are called crop belt, corn belt, wheat belt, cotton belt, and tobacco belt. Wheat is one of the popular cereals grown in North America, especially in Canada and USA. The prairie region provides the best soil for wheat cultivation. Since the population is low, lot of surplus production is obtained, which can be exported. Maize is popularly known as corn. It is grown extensively in United States and Mexico. Most of the maize is used as feed crop for the feeding cattle and pigs. They are raised for meat in Mexico. Maize is the staple food grain, but today maize is grown as a check crop. The other popular crops are barley, oat and potato. Barley and oat can be grown in cold weather. Beer is brewed from barley. Oats is used as feeding crop for animals. Potato is also grown in the continent, which serve as a food crop. Cotton and tobacco are grown as cash crops in the continent. The cotton belt lies along the Mississippi Valley. USA and Mexico are important producers of long staple cotton. Tobacco grown in South USA, Cuba, Jamaica, and Mexico. The USA ranks second after China among major tobacco growing countries of the world. Sugarcane is another important crop grown here. Cuba is the third largest producer of sugarcane in the world, so popularly called the sugar ball of the world. Sugar beet is also grown in USA. It is a major source of making sugar after sugarcane. Coffee and coca are the tropical plantation crops grown in the parts of Central America and West Indies. Fruit like grapes, oranges, lime, apple, pears, peaches, etc. are grown in California, Florida, New Jersey and areas around urban centers. California produces 90% of the wine by using grapes in North America. Therefore, California is called as wine country. That's all from this chapter. Thank you very much for paying attention. Have a nice day ahead.